Sunday's shutout loss to the Colts. It was the first time Dallas has been shut out since 2003. Dak Prescott said, quote, Sunday's loss is a wake-up call. And Ezekiel Elliott added, quote, we needed a reality check. The Cowboys were rolling before Sunday, winning five straight. Next up for Dallas, a home game Sunday against the Bucks on Fox. So, Shannon, who are the real Cowboys? The team that won five straight or the team that was shut out on Sunday?
I believe they're closer to the team that was shut out on Sunday.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Now, this is also the same Zeke that said, you know, hey, loss was good for us.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh. Now,
that's what I said yesterday.
Whoa. Hold on. Time out.
I did say that.
Yeah.
If losses are good for you, why don't teams try to do it more often?
Hmm.
Why do they practice? Why don't they just show up?
Hmm.
If losses are so good.
Well, if you won five in a row, you don't really have to worry about the next
one. Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, but when you've lost five of the eight, you probably should try to win as many as you can.
Mm-hmm.
But that's neither here nor there. We'll get to that in a second. Again, you see, the thing is that, yes, they won five games in a row,
mm-hmm.
but all those games came, they were within one score.
Mm-hmm.
So just as easily they won that game, they could have easily lost. And what gave me cause for concern, it was that I looked at what they did against the Eagles.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Dak Prescott had his best statistical day as a Cowboy.
Mm-hmm.
455, three touchdowns. Amari Cooper had a career day receiving the ball, 217. Zeke had 40 touches, over 200 scrimmage yards. But you needed overtime in order to win this ball game.
Mm.
So that gave me some concern because I'm like, hold on. You guys had career days and you still need overtime?
Mm.
Now, Jerry Jones told me after the Saints win, he said, this bunch, this team won't be the same. I'm serious. You win something like this against a team well coached, those kind of players, whoo, you'll get the.
Wait, he didn't tell you that. He told the world.
Said, hold on.
Or did he call you and tell
you? Time out.
I don't know. Well, I'm just asking.
I didn't ask you a question.
I thought that was a press conference.
I didn't ask you a question.
You said he told you. Did he not say he told me?
He did say that.
It's figuratively speaking.
Oh,
I'm not talking in a literal sense.
Well, I didn't know.
You did know.
I have to. I can't follow.
Yes, you did.
I'm not on your level. I'm not in the Hall of Fame.
Okay, okay. Jerry says this is a changer in here. These guys, they're different cats not going forward.
Different cats. Different cats.
The old cats look like the new cats on Sunday. Mm-hmm. They got shut out.
Mm-hmm.
So what am I to do, Skip Bayless?
Mm.
A team that got doors blown off them at home by the Tennessee Titans.
Mm-hmm.
And see, this is why I think they're basically the same. You know, they're closer to this team, Skip. Because when you look at it, this was a team, prior to them going into that winning streak,
mm-hmm.
hadn't won a game on the road.
Mm.
They hadn't put back-to-back wins together.
Mm.
They hadn't put 20 points in back-to-back games. So this leads me to believe, as great as they're playing,
mm-hmm.
as great as they were playing, if you could say that's great, beating mm-hmm. mediocre ball clubs, because other than the Saints,
hmm.
do we know if any of those other teams are going to make the playoffs?
Hmm.
Huh? You can answer that.
No, I...
Oh, you
it's
like
not
to
my turn.
In. You like to
I just got
in.
Shut up.
No, no, no.
I got shush.
Answer.
And I can't. And we have dead air because you're looking at me because you don't have anything else to say.
No, go ahead. You
are out of ammunition.
No, I'm just asking
you. And now
question.
You want me to talk and I'm not going to
Why
talk.
Why not?
Because you shamed me into silence.
No, I didn't shame you into silence. You just wanted to speak. Jerry didn't tell you. He told the world.
Well, I want to know. I thought maybe he called you. He likes you.
You know I was speaking figuratively. But that's okay. But that's neither here nor there. Skip, I think the inconsistency that Dak Prescott has shown this year and basically throughout his career, I think that's going to be a problem for them. The Colts, physically. Mm. You talk about your defense and how good they were. Mm. The Colts, physically.
Mm.
Dominated them.
Mm.
They bullied them.
Mm.
Andrew Luck didn't even get touched. DeMarcus, you told me DeMarcus Lawrence Taylor, the only time he saw Andrew Luck was at the coin toss.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't lay a hand on him.
That is correct.
Didn't lay a hand on him.
Yeah, keep talking. I like this.
Laundry.
You preaching.
Got this.
Are you listening, Dallas Cowboys?
The equipment manager just hung Luck's jersey right back up in his locker, Jenny.
Mm.
He ain't needed that.
Yeah.
Hey, no perspiration.
He didn't even break his
No grass stains or nothing on it.
Didn't need to be washed.
But that's your defense, your physical.
He didn't break his sweat because he only threw for 192. 192. Yeah. That wasn't exactly like torture.
But
hold on. What about old Mac? Return of the Mac.
Mm.
Ran through y'all like 40 going north.
Did he?
Went through him like Sherman went through Atlanta.
Yeah.
But 60-mile stretch.
Mm.
But that's neither here nor there. Skip, man, look. You are who we thought you were. Y'all know you got all up, all happy. You won 5 straight, and you thought you're going to win some due, but I'm going to get it all back.
Thought I was going to win some due?
Yeah, you thought.
I think a week ago you conceded.
I'm going to get it back. No, I changed. Huh? Recount.
Oh, you're recounting the due? Yep. You want to get back in the race after you conceded?
No, don't worry about it. Oh. All I'm saying is this. You're closer to what you displayed on mm-hmm. Sunday than you were during those 5-game winning streaks. Because even in the 5-game winning streak, you showed considerable flaws. But the other team was just more flawed than you were.
Oh, okay. So, Shannon Sharpe, I want that same energy that you just displayed next Monday. And then I want it
against Tampa.
Following Monday.
Oh, you want it against Tampa.
We could actually clinch the division. Who knew?
Against Tampa.
And that could clinch 6 cases of Diet Mountain Dew for me. Because I already won 1 head up on Eagles versus Cowboys at Jerry World. So now I'm up to 11 cases, and this would make it 17 cases if Dallas beats Tampa on Sunday. So I want the same energy from you next Monday. Thank you very much. Is that okay?
You need that energy.
And if you'd like, because you're so full of yourself today, I will increase our stakes since you think Philly's back in it now.
No, I don't think
we can go 4 cases and 4 cases because it's still up for grabs.
No, it's not.
It's 8-6 versus 7-7. It's only a 1-game lead
you
for my woeful Dallas Cowboys.
Oh, you gotta
my exposed Dallas Cowboys. My garbage Dallas Cowboys are only 1 game up on your Eagles, but I'll increase the stakes.
I'm glad you understand
you
that
like
garbage. I understand that you understand that they're trash. But here's the thing. I love how you do. See,
I don't do it.
You stand on top of the table and pine because you know you only need 1 game and you're playing Tampa.
Mm-hmm.
But you didn't have this energy last week. You didn't have this energy.
By the way, Philly hosts the Houston Texans. Are they any good? They're pretty good. And Washington has to go to Tennessee. Washington's a 10-point
but you just
underdog.
But you just told me how they struggled against the Jets. They were down by 5, 3 points, 4 points.
I was just... These are just facts. This is what's about to happen. Philly's actually a 1-point favorite over the Houston Texans. So what does that tell you?
At home, 1 point.
Well, that's because they had a big quarterback change to Nick Foles over Carson Wentz, and all of a sudden Vegas said, "Uh-oh."
But you told me Foles is the better quarterback, so Vegas should have.
No, I mean they're starting to lean back to Philadelphia here because I thought Tennessee, the Texans going to Philly would be, I don't know, I thought they might be 4 or 5 point favorite.
Really?
Yeah. I did, but all of a sudden Nick Foles.
But they just struggled. You just told the world they just struggled against the.
So back to my Dallas Cowboys. I'm going to repeat what I've said several times in the last few weeks on this show. In all my years of following football, in all my years of following my Dallas Cowboys back to 1961, that's a long time ago. These Cowboys are the most frustrating team I have ever rooted for in any sport. I have ridden the roller coaster with them all year long. I have thrown my jersey away. I have retrieved my jersey out of the trash because that's what they do to my psyche.
Should have set it on fire after Sunday.
Okay. So they can be really, really good or they can be really, really bad. Sometimes in the same game against Philly, the second Philly game at Jerry World, were they not really bad in that game and did really, really good down the stretch?
Yes.
I'm going to throw the stats out again. Dak Prescott was merely 17 of 20 in the fourth quarter and overtime for 243 yards and 3 touchdowns without a turnover.
Had 206.
You know what?
And 1 interception.
You know what? That is Brady-esque down the stretch. That's like Super Bowl Brady.
And guess what happened? Brady took the L. But you keep telling me Dak what he did in the fourth quarter in overtime, but he had fewer yards in 4 quarters against the Colts. Mm. So which am I supposed to believe? Will the real Dak Prescott please stand up?
So here's what the deal is with my Cowboys. When it has mattered most, they have risen and they have shown. Every time it's been do or die backs to the wall, or every time they faced road embarrassment when they went back to the scene of the crime at Atlanta. What happened a year ago in Atlanta? What happened to my Cowboys? Do you remember?
They're a different team.
Okay. 8 sacks were allowed that day. It was horrendous. It's still a nightmare to me. Dak Prescott still, I think, hasn't quite recovered from that football
game.
Why
not?
And they went down there and righted the wrong of that game. So every time they faced national TV embarrassment, Drew Brees, what happened? They rose and they shone.
Titan.
And when it mattered the most, no, it didn't matter. They didn't really need that game. That was midseason. It wasn't a do-or-die game.
Oh, no, Skip, did you realize how many games you had already lost?
Okay, it wasn't do-or-die. It wasn't backs to the wall yet. Every time this team has been pushed to the brink, it has responded, and it will respond again because my gut feeling is I'm leaning way more toward really good than really bad. So what happened? I know this is third level thinking for you, and I know it's just hard to sort of comprehend, but this is what happened on Sunday.
Try me out.
They woke up with a 2-game lead in the NFC East after all their woeful performances, all their debacles, the Tennessee nightmare. They wake up on Sunday morning in where? Where are we? In Indianapolis? With a 2-game lead in the NFC East, and they know that later in the day, Washington is going to lose at Jacksonville because they got Josh Johnson at quarterback, right? Josh Johnson? They're going to lose at Jacksonville.
How? With Cody Kessler at quarterback for the Jags.
But the Eagles are going to the Rams, and they are going to lose because they got Nick Foles back at quarterback, right? And what happened? Everything went south on the same day. They went way south because they came out and played like that game didn't really matter to them because it didn't, and that's how they performed. They came out with no incentive. They came out with no motivation. They had no urgency. They had no energy. They were lifeless from the beginning, except for the offense drove the ball, but then they get a field goal block.
So they were lifeless then?
The defense was lifeless from the start. Okay. The defense that most people hung their helmets on, the Dallas Cowboy defense, they got those two hot young linebackers, right? They got the tackling Dutchman. That defense got blown off the field in Indianapolis. That defense came in leading the NFL in yards allowed per rush. And it got wiped off the map by 178 yards rushing. I was not upset with my offense, because I told you yesterday, I give Dak a B for the game. They had long drive after long drive after long drive. The defense could not stop Dink and Duck Luck, and Marlon Mack just ran wild on them. So that's just effort. I've never seen more missed tackles in one game. My defense did not show up. But when it gets pressed, when it gets pushed, when its backs are to the wall and it's on the edge of the cliff, you watch, it will show back up.
If you don't mind me asking, Skip, when can the defense have an off game and the offense ride to the rescue and save the day?
There was one game, and this is pre-Amari Cooper. Explain this one to me. Mm-hmm. Jacksonville comes into Dallas with the best defense in pro football statistically. Mm-hmm. Statistically, they are number one in yards allowed and points allowed. And at halftime, it's 24-0 Dak Prescott on the way to 40-7.
Hold on.
Listen to this, 40-7. There's no Amari Cooper. There's no go-to receiver. How did they do that? Because all of a sudden,